this is the most important thing we have to understand. America needs leadership right now, and America does not have that. America needs a campaigner-in-chief. Instead, we don't. America needs a commander-in-chief. Instead, we have a campaigner-in-chief. And that's exactly what continues to happen, whether it's the decision to go to zero troops in Iraq, which gives a green line to Iran, or whether it's the decision to shut down, which you have heard is a win-win situation for the United States of America and for a new trading partner, which is Canada. We cannot continue to send the hard-earned American taxpayer dollars to OPEC, nothing but despot, dictators, autocrats, and theocrats. For 22 years, I served in the United States military, and I've been on the battlefields in the Middle East, where the funds that we are sending to these countries are in turn being turned on our young men and women in combat. It is about time that I ask this from the media. Stop being afraid of this president. Stand up to him and call him out on the shirking of his duties and responsibilities. The House Republicans are passing pieces of legislation after pieces of legislation about jobs. Stop allowing this president to demagogue and use the big microphone that he has. Call him out on what we see happening right now. Again, punting on promoting the prosperity of the American people. Do we need to have another year of trillion-dollar deficit? How much more debt do we need to have added? The fact that the United States of America now has a debt-to-GDP ratio of 101% is not far behind the 128% of Greece. And here we got a president that's gone off to Australia playing golf in Hawaii. And you guys allow him to make this decision to shut down this Keystone XL project. The media needs to call out this president and stop coming over here to the House Republicans and telling us what we're not doing. We're the ones taking action. The guy sitting at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue is destroying this country. Thank you.